In this video, I want to talk about what ASME Y14.45-2021 says about reporting profile. So it gives a description of a quick calculation to figure this out. There's a quicker way to do it, which I'll show you toward the end. Now, very simple part, right? We've got a planar feature. This works the exact same if it's a complex shape or a radius or whatever it is. This is just the easiest for me to draw. We're restrained to datum A and the 3 degrees of freedom that matter. So what I'm saying is this plane is free to translate, left and right, in and out of the board, and it's free to rotate about the Z axis. That's not gonna affect our measurements here. So even with a single datum reference, we're controlling size, location, orientation, and form with just this feature control frame. Now, if we zoom in on this spot, we've got a true profile, right? That's just a plane, right? I'm drawing in 2 dimensions, but it exists in 3 dimensions. And that is not going to move. That is fixed with a basic dimension. It's not free to rotate or translate. Now, the methodology in ASME Y14.45 is to establish your tolerance zone boundary about the true profile. Okay, so I've said we're 40 thousandths, split evenly. All right, there's no unequally disposed symbol, so we're split evenly by default. What we're going to do is find this variable here called the growth parameter. The growth parameter is the closest the point comes to the tolerance zone boundary, if it's inside of it, or the furthest away it is if it's outside of the tolerance zone boundary. So in our case, we've got 5 thousandths and 7 thousandths. Now this is a measure of how far the surface is away from the tolerance zone boundary, not how far it is away necessarily from the true profile. And I'll get to that. That's a more practical way to do it. But we're going to take the smaller of the two numbers here. So here we're 7 thousandths away, here we're 5 thousandths. This is closer to the tolerance zone boundary. So that's what we're going to take into account to calculate our profile. So all we have to do here is remember that this is going to be a negative as our growth parameter. If it's inside of the tolerance zone boundary, it's negative. If it's outside, it's positive. And you'll hopefully see why in a second. So here's our calculation. Our stated tolerance, what's in the feature control frame, plus 2 times the growth parameter. Now, if it's inside of the boundary, it's negative. So what this does is it's always going to be smaller than the stated tolerance if it's inside of the tolerance zone boundary. In this case, we've got 30 thousandths, right? That would be what gets reported as the profile. Now, this is different than total indicator reading. If I zero an indicator right here on the true profile, indicator goes up, indicator goes down, right? I'm gonna get a total indicator reading. That's gonna be, that's gonna end up being 28 thousandths, right? Because this distance is 15, right? 5 minus 20. This distance is 13, 7 minus 20. So our total indicator reading is different from what Y14.45 wants us to report. Now this comes up when you put things on a coordinate measuring machine. Sometimes it'll spit out this number. You might go measure it on a surface plate, and you might have a part like this, right? Where you measure it on a surface plate, right? 15, you double it, or you measure 15 thousandths, and you're like, hey, it's only 15 thousandths away from where it's supposed to be. Why isn't it 15? When you put this exact same part on a coordinate measuring machine, it's gonna measure 30, right? So you have this disparity here, and that's the point of this video, to explain that disparity. If the surface is outside of the tolerance zone boundary, this becomes a positive number. So when we make that positive, it's going to be additive to the stated tolerance, and what we report, our actual profile is 50, which is much larger than this, the part would fail. And we can see that by inspection right here, just looking at it. But that's the methodology. Now, as I mentioned before, there's an easier way to do this, and it's just taking the worst measurement, right? The measurement that's furthest away from where it's supposed to be, and doubling it. And you may have heard of that technique before. Take the worst and double it. In this case, we're looking at 20 plus 5, right? That's our worst measurement, 25 thousandths away from the true profile. We double it, and that'll tell us how much tolerance zone was consumed. Another way to think about it, you may have seen it explained as two parallel planes centered on the true profile that collapse, right? Whatever stops it from collapsing, right? The other plane stops as well, right? They don't continue advancing because it's centered on the true profile. Any of these techniques gets you to the same answer. The only one that won't is trying to measure with total indicator reading. Now, you can still measure it with the indicator, don't get me wrong there. All you would do is find the worst, right, reading, because you're gonna be zeroed on the true profile. So say you get positive 10 and negative 12. You would take that negative 12, double it, 24 thousandths would be what you report for your profile. Now, real quick, if instead of a basic dimension, it's a plus or minus dimension, this now gets calculated like parallelism. These two planes are no longer centered on a true profile. The true profile is essentially variable. It can move around. So you're checking the profile. You don't have this fixed tolerance zone boundary. You're gonna collapse these planes all the way, right? The planes are going to be oriented, right, to datum A here. So it's going to act a lot like parallelism, or exactly like parallelism, right? These planes, again, parallel to datum A, but they're free to move up and down to capture that surface. You can do this on a surface plate by just running an indicator over it, and it's total indicator reading. Fairly simple. The difference between this and parallelism is basically nil on a flat surface. If it's a curved surface, that's a totally different thing. That is not easy to measure on a plus or minus dimension, right? That's just gonna require more effort to verify that surface. If there's no datum reference at all, or tolerance zone, or the profile is now free to rotate, just like a flatness. Right? This is more difficult with the indicator because now I've got to present this surface to the indicator in such a way that it's easy to measure, but our tolerance zone is free to rotate, it'll collapse, it's just the distance between the high points of the actual surface. So in that way, it acts just like flatness. So that's it for this video. Just a real quick chat about this. I know it's confusing for some people when you hear that, take the worst and double it. Like, why? Why would I do that? Well, this is why. It's an ASME Y14.45, relatively new standard, 2021. Some of this stuff was in the math standards, Y14.51. Yeah, Y14.51, which I'll be honest, I don't think that many people read, so. The 14.5, I think, is easier to read and has some valuable information. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below.